So we're now in a position where we can compile our own version of Java from source, though, rather than just the binary. So let's read what it says here. This is about proving that the compiled version has got 100% compatibility. So let's download the files. It'll probably take a while, yeah, 18 meg. Test harness and a patch. So I suppose we could check we've got Java working. Right, let's log out. And no, let's log in. Like that. That should update everything. Yeah, that's better. I could have done profile in theory, actually. But that proves we've got a running Java environment. I'm not sure if the JavaAct runs. Yeah, the JavaAct, the compiler runs. So just got to, let's just see what we need to do while that's downloading. Test harness, there's the patch. Before proceeding, you should ensure that your environment path variable contains the location of the Java compiler. It's the only requirement for the environment. Modern Java installations do not need Java home and class paths. Is not used here. Furthermore, OpenJDK developers recommend to unset Java home, so let's just make sure we haven't got that set. It isn't. Oh, it is set, okay. That may be. Oh, they do actually unset it as part of the installation, so that's okay. That may be for older packages that require Java home to be set. Only wish to install the Java runtime environment. So it depends. If you're a developer, you'll want the full development kit, so you won't want to do that. But if you just want the runtime to run some Java program, then you can use this and you'll get a smaller installation. And there's two JDKs. There's the binary one we downloaded and copied, and there's the one will be the one that we've built. So this will switch over to the one we've just built. And also, if you notice, the version, the binary version, oh, it is the same version, sorry. Right, thought it was an earlier version for some reason. Oh, they suffixed it with bin to show that that's the binary version that was downloaded. So the one that we're building from source is going into the directory without the dash bin on the end. So there's quite a few extra options there. The certificates again will need to be reconfigured. Okay, so just wait for it to finish downloading. It looks like that's complete now. So let's expand the first file. Let's go back to sources, BLFS. Let's just check the disk space again. Well, I've nearly used half the disk space. So this uses 5 gig of disk space, so I've still got plenty of room. So JDK, that doesn't look like the same file actually. Let's OpenJDK star. Well, what is that downloaded to? Okay, then see name they've got in the text is different from the actual download file. So that is the right file. Okay. Right, so that's extracted. And first we've got the test harness, so let's install that first. Got patch to install to allow it to run with make 4.3. And check the path, we've seen it running. So let's do unset Java home and copy this bash command in. Let's see what options we've got. Enable unlimited crypto. So it's responsibility of the user to ensure proper adherence to the law. So you'd have to check whether you can use that switch or not. So with use of wire and build. So I need to set the number of jobs. I can't see where that is. Is that an extra one then? Default build system, we use the number of CPUs minus one. There's JT reg. That's there. There's giflib, LCMS, libjpg, libpng, zlib, equals system. So we've got all of those. That's that lot there. With version build, currently the build systems does not include the build number and the version string, it has to be specified here. So it's build number 10. With version PRE, this allows you to prefix version string with a custom string. So you might want to put something in there. And opt. Add an optional build description to the version string. And then with CA certs and with bootJDK, the switch provides a location of the temporary JDK is normally not needed if Java is found in the path. Okay, so we shouldn't need that. So we've unset the Java home. Let's copy this and just change the prefix to something like, let's read the description again. let's prefix a version string with a custom string, so we could call it something like BLFS, for example. And the version opt string, let's attach, add an optional build description of to the version string, so we could put something like Kernotex, for example. And copy the rest in. Okay. It doesn't like that backslash there. I probably didn't press enter. Oh, it's the characters haven't been picked up again. That's what it is. Yeah, it's something about the copying that's not working right. It's got two double quotes for some reason. Let's try that. It doesn't like the minus in BLFS. So I'm gonna get rid of that. I'll actually get rid of the ones out of the Kernotex. Now it does say that this configuration is an old, overridden an old configuration because I've rerun it twice, and generally it's safe to do that, but normally I clear out and start again. I'm not even going to run make clean, I'm going to clear out the directory again and start from scratch to be sure that it's an absolutely clean build. So now we can go back into it, extract this JTReg program, run the patch again. So the Java home should still be unset. It is. So let's recall this config command. Found four cores. Actually, I didn't set that jobs, did I? Let's try running it. jobs equals n. So maybe I do have to put it on the command line, right? I'll have to start this again, unfortunately. I'll do what's suggested in the book. For what seems to be quite a big package, it's worth getting this absolutely right. So let's just do, oh, need to cd into it, don't we? Cd JDK. Then there's the sed command. Oh, sorry, the patch command. Just make sure we're doing this right. Yep. And let's recall the configure command. To add in, oh, it says here the build system not support the minus J, so command exclamation for with jobs and with test jobs as well. So it doesn't mention that. So it looks like we need to put both of these in. It was 4. And with test jobs equals 4. So let's, again, the instructions seem to be as if they've been written for one version and the package has been updated, but the instructions haven't been tweaked to follow the latest version, because that with test jobs it doesn't seem to be mentioned anywhere else. So I can see anyway. But I think that's probably the configure we can go with, so let's start by building again. No, it still doesn't like it. Even though it's better, so that maybe that switch doesn't even work anymore. So let's do as it says there, and do make jobs. 4 images. No, okay, so we're going to have to unset the, let's take that out. What's it called? Make flags equals make images. That's better. need to execute JT reg program and set the number of concurrent tests by adding the conc x value in the below command. In the command below, tests will run sequentially otherwise. So we need to export this JT Java. Just check that. Okay, and looks like this is the command we add the minus conc colon 4 to. And then unset JT Java. No, it doesn't like that. So once again, the instructions aren't quite in step with the version that we've got to install. Right, it says in jtreg doc, jtreg usage. Let's view that. Jtreg doc, jtreg usage.txt. Quick look down to see what options there are. Timeout option. Concurrency factor. Okay, so that is correct. So I wonder why that's not working. What is conc colon 4? And unset JT Java. Ah, have we added it into the wrong place? Maybe we should put it here, minus conc colon 4. It looks a bit better. Okay, so wait for these to finish now. Okay, so the tests have finished and got around 40s. It says we had 45 and 4 errors. So we can install the package now. And link, create a new link. So if we look at the opt directory before and afterwards, you can see at the moment it's pointing to the OpenJDK one, and afterwards it'll be pointing to the one we've just installed, JDK. And there you can see it's switched over now. And a couple of entries here, as the required icons have already been installed. A couple of desktop files. And any configuration we've got is for the CA certificates. Type the correct password and it works. And that's that done. So we'll come out in theory. Top Java version. You can see that it's the one which is compiled because it's got BLFS put in. The version signature and the build version has not only got BLFS in, but it's got Kernotex in as well. So that is the end of Java.